let's focus on the four pillars that we have. We have eat for life, move for life, balance for life, and breathe for life, which is really a no-brainer, is don't smoke. So I won't have to beat that puppy because I think that's like an obvious thing. But we'll go over a little bit and I'll hammer anybody who's smoking, and that's okay too. Eat for life, it's encourage healthy eating through education and improved food options. I want to go back to this slide. This is by Darush Mazafarian. He's from Massachusetts, he's in the Harvard hospital system. And he's very famous and very well respected. And he put this together as the etiology, or the really underpinning of how all of our chronic conditions have evolved, or certainly most of them. And this was done in 2008 in Circulation, which is like the American Heart Association's journal, and it's a very prestigious journal. If you notice here, you have in red, death. And you have coronary artery disease underneath that, cardiac arrhythmias, heart failure, stroke, cognitive decline, right? Dementia. Then you have the symptoms and disability, and subclinical vascular disease, and you have hyperlipidemia, high cholesterol, high blood pressure, diabetes, inflammation, thrombosis, clots, arrhythmias. And all of that is downstream from being obese, having vascular dysfunction, and metabolic dysfunction. And all of that is caused by just three things: poor dietary habits, physical inactivity, and smoking. I saw a cartoon, I think it was by Dean Ornish. It's great, and it sums it all up. Here you have a photo of these guys in suits on the ground, mopping up all of these puddles of water. And behind them, which is your diseases, your chronic conditions, mopping the puddles up. And behind them is a big basin sink, like the kind you put mops in, and the spigot's on, and the water is overflowing the basin and spilling all over the floor. What we do in medicine is mop up the puddles, but it's the spigot that has to be shut off, or there's no end in sight. That's the spigot is this. And everything else downstream is going to stay that way. It's going to continue to be a problem until we do something about the spigot. Okay, so let's delve a little deeper in all the components that what I've just been talking about, just to give you a flavor for why it's important to pay attention to these lifestyles. Okay, food. Beyond food as calories. We all think of food as calories, okay? And it's been marketed as calories. But although some people would say a calorie is a calorie is a calorie, I guess if you put it in a flask and burn it, I guess that's true. But calories come in different forms in terms of the food that they're in. And some food has a lot of other health benefits, and some foods don't. So the calories might be the same, but it's the rest of the package that makes the difference. So food is information, and it regulates gene expression. When you eat something like broccoli, broccoli has these things called isothiocyanates that irritate the cell. And it causes the cell to react to it by making chemicals. It makes enzymes, and those enzymes end up being very powerful to get rid of things that are potentially toxic to you besides the broccoli. So when you eat broccoli, and the reason broccoli has that stuff is because, you know, like onions and other things, they're chemicals for the plant to protect itself from invaders. And the plant's invaders is another animal, insect, or whatever. So when that invader that bites the plant, it releases these chemicals, which are noxious. And so the animal goes someplace else. I mean, the plants can't run away. That's why they do it. So we can take advantage of that by eating foods that, in the same way, stimulate our cells that are being irritated to make chemicals to get rid of those toxins. Not the broccoli itself, but all these other things that may come down the pike. When they talk about cytochrome P450 enzymes or pathways that get rid of things, like you take a medication and you say, well, that medication interacted and caused it to be more destroyed by a certain enzyme system in your body or made it more active. And we have to be careful. It's a certain cytochrome system that will affect you in the foods you eat, or actually with the pharmaceutical companies, those chemicals are being affected by what your body has. What they don't say is that all of those enzyme systems that were made that are affecting us when we take pills, they weren't designed for pills. They were designed thousands of years ago for the foods you ate. Because maybe 10,000 years ago, all you had was apples and nothing else, and you ate 30 of them because you were starving to death. And so those systems in our bodies were designed so that if you develop toxic levels, if you'd ate too much of it, it would degrade it, it would metabolize it, it would get rid of it. So the system was set up to get rid of things that could be detrimental to your health. They weren't set up for medications. It just so happens medications are affected by them. But that's not why they were there. So your system, your body was set up to protect itself against eating too much of any particular food, just to as much as it could, sugar being probably the exception to that. So it's self-regulating. So when you eat food, your body over tens of thousands of years has been adjusted to work well with the foods you eat.